sticking to the manuscripts, this is followed by two jigs. Now, the first jig is Money in Both Pockets, and it's from the Alex Sutherland manuscript. Alex Sutherland was a great teacher. He also learned from Peter Kennedy and taught widely around South Leitrim and collected an awful lot of music and sent tunes in to the Folklore Commission. So he was a wonderful man also, but not as good as the next man that's mentioned, Greer. The second jig is from the Greer manuscript. Now, Greer had no name for this tune in the manuscript, but in O'Neill's book, it's called Father O'Carroll. But always Greer's tunes are that little bit better than every other version, so we are calling it Canon O'Carroll.
Much. We'll continue now with some reels associated with Sligo mainly. The first one is the Monasteraidin reel, and this version we got from the great fiddle player James Kelly. And the next tune then is known as Hanley's, and it's a tune from Louth, South Armagh, that we got from Jerry Fiddle O'Connor. And then the last one is
Primrose.
The Primrose Lass, back to Sligo again.
Thank you.
couple of tunes. The first tune I learned from Patsy Hanley back at, say, around 1980 or maybe before that, is called The Navvy on the Line. And I really liked the tune, and he made a great job of it. Like, Patsy was one of the finest blue players and still is in the country. The second tune I learned from Josie McDermott is called Peg McGrath's Reel. He composed it for poor Peg McGrath. She died tragically in an accident. She was knocked down by a lorry. She was cycling on a bicycle, and she was knocked over. And the third tune is McFadden's. So we'll try those.
Yeah, it's called, the first one is called Salut on the Mers. We learned this from a German guitarist. Actually, he was in Charlie McGettigan's show yesterday. And good character. The second one is called Pacificus of Coana.
Ooh.
Big words.
I knew that.
And I'm definitely not pronouncing it right. But we might play them right. Might.
What CD was that, Porrick? I'm
And with that, Keish Carrigan. A huge, big, thriving metropolis of a city, Keish Carrigan.
Yeah. That was a set of reels. The first one was called Free and Easy. The second one, the Boys of Mallon County Donegal. That one was for Anne in the front row there somewhere, from Inishowen. And the third one is the Boyne Hunt. We're going to follow now with something completely different. Patrick Weston Joyce was a man who was a historian and a writer and a collector of traditional music, and he had a particular interest in Irish place names, and he wrote some very important some important academic works on that. But he also collected some fantastic tunes and has many collections published of Irish songs and dance music. A lot of his work was done in County Limerick, and one of his sources was a man called Joe Martin from Kilfinan, County Limerick, and he was the man who gave him this next piece we're going to play. Jackie actually found it. It's the first song in one of the Joyce collections. In the Irish language, it's called Mhirch is Mhirch, meaning the great sadness. And but the opening line is An Ciú Dríochta, which means the magic mist. And it tells the story of a young man who wished for mist to descend so that he could walk with his love on the street and no one could see him. That was his wish. How times have changed. So An Ciú Dríochta. And after that, we're going to play a Leitrim tune. In fact, it was collected by a man called Stephen Greer. I have a great interest in this man's collection. He was born in 1824, lived in Gort Letra for a lot of his life. He was a neighbour, although separated by over a century by Thurlogh O'Carolan. But anyway, he collected the next tune called the Stafford Dance. So Ciú Dríochta and the Stafford Dance.
Thank you. Up Leitrim.
The first song I'm going to do is called Slána Gospanacht. It's a song that I got from Mairéadh Ní Flaherta, who's a great singer from Connemara. And the song is a macaronic song, so it's half in English and half in Irish. The title of the song, the full title, is Slána Gospanacht le Búru an Tíl, which means goodbye and good luck to the worries of life. And in the song, the boy is trying to convince the girl to come away with him and go off and get married. So in the end, she does agree to go off. So it's a happy ending, which is not very common, I suppose, in a lot of traditional songs. But this one is a nice, happy ending. So Slán agus Bannacht. She was so handsome, gar hitch me in the roll of it. Dog as she hiding, he gar the lore mochree. I asked her name, the cathay unrig fanny her, has the sun not to a cryo mochree. My heart it will break if you don't come along with me, slan a caspan a claburu and thee. Kalin me go. Yander na farig tog ga kanasta het asach ma heel I being so early o she should be clocked the hum made my own parents and me disagree I'll hush last a star don't eat the full on tama I'll tell you a story of a child of that I'm a young man who is totally in love with you. Surely my heart is from roguery free. I should go, you bought a rock shirt, trying to flatter me. But I ain't ever love, no go, ain't ever grieve. I've neither wheat, potatoes, or anything. Love you. There's an ale house nearby, spy with the Martin on. If you're satisfied, I'll try out my free. Early next morning, we'll send for the clergyman. Bye, my kango, ben a mustante. Bye, my to go, want to water some paddock. Then we will take the road home with all speed. When the reckoning is paid,
the torn jacket, the title.
Okay.
Yeah. And the Longford Spencer. And thanks, Joe. Well played here. Bit of a frog here. Thank you.
Tommy Guihan.
Thank you.
Joe Kennedy, thanks very much. Thank We're going to take a little break now, and we'll be back for more after that.
Thank you.
I'll chance another song. This one is called The Plowboy, and I got the song from Pauline Handley, who's a great singer, the late wife of Patsy Handley, the flute player from Roscommon. And Pauline would have taught me like most of my singing, so I started off going to lessons with her when I was very young, and she taught me all the ins and outs of traditional singing, so it was great to have somebody of that quality of singer and the repertoire that she had, like just living down the road from me. So it was brilliant to have her. So she gave me this song, and Patsy told me actually that they were in the bog one day, and Patsy's mother was with them, and it was so quiet and peaceful in the bog that Patsy's mother just said, "And the birds in the bushes were silent all round." And Pauline said to her, "Oh, that must be from a song. Like, that sounds like a line of a song, you know?" And she said, "Oh, I don't know." So she kept at her anyway until she kind of recalled all the words of the song. And then Pauline, as far as I know, put a tune to it. But I heard since then that there is a version of it, but we're not sure where it came from. Or do you know? It's kind of Englishy, kind of like an English folk kind of a song. But this is our version of it anyway. So this is The Plowboy. There was a rich lady in the far country. Sweethearts she had many of every degree. She was robed in great splendor and was free from all care, till her father's son plowboy her heart did ensnare. One day as she walked down her father's domain, she spied her young Willie a-plowing the plain. His whistle so sweetly brought the world to resound, and the birds in the bushes were silent all round. She called on young Willie to halt for a while. He turned around with a nod and a smile. Her cheeks blushed like roses, and this she did say, "You are deep in my thoughts, love, alone as I stray." "We will go to America, and that very soon. We will get married and have a long honeymoon. We will go to America like thousands before, and I'll be true to my plowboy wherever I go." Shout out to the dancers down the back. Fair play to you. Thank you.
Thank you.